All right, welcome back to the layout. I've been doing a lot of track work recently and testing a lot of my track work, and the layout itself is about 95% complete. But I also decided to do a little bit more work on the harbor. I changed some things in the harbor, actually regained some of my water area, so I was able to dock a few more boats in there. But today I decided to do some operations, and today is actually going to be the first mini operating session for the layout. So I'm going to operate the Seaview Avenue area, the harbor, lower yard, and I'm going to be using a simple wheel report. A friend of mine is coming over, he doesn't know he's operating yet, so it's going to be a surprise for him. If you take a look at it, it's pretty simple. Get the initial of the car, the number of the car, the kind of car, whether it's a box car, reefer, hopper, flat, whether it's a load or empty, where is it going from and to, what type of movement is it? Is it a place or a pull? I also have some notes here. For instance, the first one is permission from the dispatcher is needed to occupy the Schwartz running track. If you look at the track right here, that is the Schwartz running track. It's not controlled, it's in the yard, but it's controlled by the dispatcher. So you actually need permission from the dispatcher to switch that industry right there. Also, the switch right underneath the seaboard car is BH switch, which is Bridgeport Harbor switch. Since this train's sitting on the main line, which is 3, if you're operating in the yard, you need permission from the dispatcher to open up that switch, considering it comes off the main line. It's not a powered switch, it's a hand thrown, but you still need permission. And also, the engine that we're going to be using today is 646. In order for that engine to come out onto track 3, he's going to need the dispatcher's permission as well, because the dispatcher controls that switch to come out to track 3. So it's going to be a pretty cool operating session, real basic, but it's my first time using a wheel report, and the next video you see is the trains switching out the layout.
Please go and check out the layout. So, good iron.
Throw the iron behind that marine building too.
At the end there?
That's Hubble Plastics.
That's Hubble?
Yep. Fox River butter car is going to stay.
Yeah, it's going to stay. Well then. It's going for a ride.
Yeah, that's fine.
Thank you.
It's pretty cool. I'm gonna try to kick the cars.
At least just delayed coupling, but I think the there we go. I gotta keep up with them with the grade. Oh, might have to wait till we get done. I don't want to kick them on a dock.
No. End up in the harbor, that'll be a bad thing.
Yeah. You want me to go on the siding then?
Yeah, I'll put you on the siding here.
Okay.
Running all the way through the other side?
Yeah. Since I don't have any traffic to deal with right now.
That's it. Clear yet, keep going. You can go just past the switch tower here.
Okay. Oh, I was gonna come back and
okay, that's fine.
Grab these cars. Which switch do I need?
You're going to need.
That's within the yard?
Yep. LY2 and LY1.
LY2. Since I need these three,
mm-hmm.
build all the cars that I need here, throw the junk over here.
Yep.
certain time.
Yeah, soon.
Throw the LY2 switch for me.
Alright, welcome back. The first operating session went very well. We spent about an hour and a half switching out Seaview Avenue, Lower Bridgeport Yard, and also the Bridgeport Harbor. We got about through half of the switch list or the wheel report, and everything ran very, very well. Again, here's another look at the switch list I set up. Very realistic, and it was a lot of fun. So tomorrow, I'll probably finish up this list and then prep for the next operating session. So thanks for watching and see you at the next update.